and welcome to the Cassandra Essentials tutorial series. My name is Robin Schumacher and I'm Vice President of Products here at DataStax. In this tutorial, we'll be taking a look at data consistency in Cassandra. So I'll first give you an overview of reading and writing data, and give you some details on how Cassandra writes data to the database. We'll do a review of the CAP theorem, talk about Cassandra's tunable data consistency. I'll show you the various strategies you have open to you for reads and writes, give you some SQL examples of those, and then we'll wrap up by telling you where you can get Cassandra. So the first thing you need to understand is Cassandra is a peer-to-peer architecture. It's not a master-slave architecture or anything similar. And this means it's a read-write-anywhere design. So you can connect to any node in your database cluster, read and write data to and from that node, and Cassandra automatically takes care of partitioning that data, replicating that data across all the nodes in your cluster, even if your database spans multiple data centers. Now let's talk a little bit more in detail how Cassandra writes data. There's some internet FUD out there that says NoSQL databases or post-relational databases really aren't safe for your data. In other words, you can lose data. Well, where Cassandra's concerned, that's absolutely false. The fact of the matter is, when you write data into Cassandra, it first writes it to a commit log for durability. And this means your data is absolutely safe. It then writes it to an in-memory structure called a memtable. And when that memtable becomes full, it flushes it to what's called an SS table, a sorted strings table, on disk. Now, even though Cassandra doesn't offer relational database style transactions with commits and rollbacks, writes are atomic at the row level. And this means all columns are written to or updated, or none are. Now, one thing Cassandra is known really well for in the industry is being the fastest database out there where writes are concerned. And this is just one small example of that. This is an independent benchmark that was recently done, and it shows Cassandra with 4 times better throughput in writes and over 12 times better throughput in a mixed workload environment for reads and updates. Didn't do too shabby either in reads, with 2 times better throughput than one of its rivals. So now let's talk about data consistency in Cassandra. And to do that, we first need to review what's called the CAP theorem. Now, this theory states that in a distributed database system, you can have 2 of 3 things. You can either have strong consistency, meaning I'm reading and writing the latest and greatest copy of a piece of data. I can have strong availability, meaning if one or more of the nodes in the distributed system goes down, the system continues to operate. Or I can have strong partition tolerance, meaning if I'm losing messages between a couple of the nodes, again, the system continues to operate well. Now, Cassandra is known for having very strong availability and partition tolerance, and because of that, some say that Cassandra does not have strong data consistency. Well, again, that's just not true. The fact of the matter is, Cassandra offers what's called tunable data consistency, and this means you get to choose how strong you want your data consistency to be. And this is done on a per operation basis. So this is not some sort of global setting for the entire database cluster or for a node. You get to choose per operation, per insert, per select, how strong you want your data consistency to be. And again, Cassandra's smart enough to handle this across multiple data centers. So now let's talk about what strategies you have open to you where writes are concerned. What options are there? You first have the any option, which says when I write a piece of data to a database cluster, it's got to succeed on one of the nodes. Doesn't matter if that node is responsible for managing that piece of data or not, as long as it makes it to one of the nodes, that's fine. The option of one says that when I write a row to Cassandra, one of the nodes responsible for managing that piece of data must respond for the write to be successful. Quorum is a little different. Quorum says I need a majority of the nodes that are responsible for that piece of data to respond back for the write to be successful. And that's determined by what's called the replication factor. So let's say I have 4 nodes in a database cluster, and I'm using a replication factor of 4, meaning I have a duplicate copy of a row on every node. Well, in that case, 3 nodes have to respond back for the write to be successful. Local quorum and each quorum deal with multiple data centers. So local quorum says I have to have a majority back from the data center that I'm connected to, and each quorum says I need a majority back from all data centers. Finally, the option of all says I have to have a response from all of the nodes managing that piece of information for the write to be successful. But let's say one of the nodes in your database cluster is down. What happens then? Well, Cassandra uses what's called the hinted handoff methodology, meaning that if I'm writing a particular piece of data to the cluster and one of those nodes is down, one of the nodes responsible for that data will store a hint for the down node. When the down node comes back online, it will pass a copy of that row over to that node so that it's brought up to date. Now let's turn our attention to reads in Cassandra. What are your options there? Well, you also have the one option here, meaning that when I read a piece of data from Cassandra, the closest node holding that data responds back. Quorum, local quorum, each quorum, and all work exactly the same way for reads as they do writes. I either need a majority of nodes to respond or all nodes to respond for the read to be successful. Now, one of the things Cassandra uses to ensure data consistency in a cluster is something called read repair. What if I read a piece of data that's stale in Cassandra? Well, what Cassandra does in the background is issue what's called a repair request to other nodes that might contain a more up-to-date copy of that row. If it finds one, it updates the node that I just read from so that the next time a read occurs, that data will be up to date. So how do these look from a SQL example, from a Cassandra query language example? Using a consistency strategy is very, very easy. You simply use the using consistency clause when you issue a select, an update, or an insert, and that invokes your strategy in Cassandra. So where can you get Cassandra? If you go to datastax.com, you will find our free Smart Start installers for Cassandra that contain the most up-to-date copy of Cassandra that's available, a free version of our DataStax Ops Center, a visual browser-based management tool, drivers and connectors, a sample database and application, automatic configuration assistance in our installers to ensure the best out-of-the-box experience, and a getting started guide. If you want to learn more information about Cassandra, again, datastax.com for our free online documentation, technical white papers, articles, and a whole lot more. So for everyone here at DataStax, I'd like to thank you for your time and wish you a great day.